Hola.
Hola.
Bienvenidos a LightSpeed Spanish.
Bienvenidos.
This is videocast. I was going to say podcast, but it's videocast number 45 for early intermediate. And we are dealing with a question that Yasin Khan, hola Yasin, has asked us about the redundant indirect object pronoun. Okay?
Okay.
Entonces, nos vemos en la segunda parte. Okay, so this is in English, yes? This is
this is in English.
Early intermediate. Now, so Yasin is saying, can you do a video on the redundant indirect object pronouns, okay?
Your favorite, Gordon.
Yeah.
You love it.
Love this. So what are the indirect object pronouns? What are the, Cynthia? Which ones are there on the list?
Metele no sos les.
Metele no sos les. And I suggest that you just repeat those until you get them, like a little rhyme. Metele no sos les. Okay? They are the ones that we use whenever there is an exchange going on. Okay? An exchange of something. So, for example, we say, I give Pedro the ball. How would that be, Cynthia?
Le di a Pedro la pelota.
Oh, I give. Present.
Le doy, perdón. You say give, sounds like give.
Give,
you
know? I know. I'm from the north.
Past.
From the north. Past, present, in the same sentence. So, I give Pedro the ball. The ball is what's happening in the exchange, okay? As soon as there's an exchange, then we need to use the pronoun. Now, the only difficulty we have is with le. Because all the rest of them...
Gosh, I wish it was the only difficulty.
All right,
Imagine the only difficulty. This little
issue, the issue we have here. Obviously, there's a lot more issues. But in this issue,
no more
the
issues
le.
Ever.
So we have... Because when I say, I give you the ball, right?
Sí.
I give you the ball. That's easy, because you...
Yeah, te doy la pelota.
Te doy la pelota. All right, so you don't really have to think about that one. Or I give you all the ball...
Use. Os doy la pelota.
Exactly. So they're quite straightforward. You're going to need to use them. It's when we get to the I give Pedro the ball, and suddenly we're into. There's a flute playing. Flute playing downstairs. Suddenly we're into
the guy with the rats.
Le doy a Pedro. La pelota. And now suddenly we've got Pedro mentioned in the sentence, yeah? And we've got le. And so lots of people ask the question, wait a minute, why if we've mentioned Pedro,
yeah,
why have we got to put a le in there?
Good question.
Yeah? You know, why not just say, doy la pelota a Pedro?
Good question.
Yeah?
Very good question. Why, Gordon?
Why? Because... Okay, and there you are. That's the end of the lesson now. We're going to go and have a cup of coffee. The reason is because the fundamental part of that sentence is le doy la pelota. That's it. That is the sentence, we're not going to get into the say, but that's the base sentence. If you want to add something extra in, like who, to whom, you can add a Pedro. But what you can't do is to take the le off. The le is fixed in that sentence. Why? Because we get this le a. Le a. In every exchange. Le a. It always goes together. The le is to the person, to him, to her, to it. Or les, also, obviously, if we're in the plural.
Mm-hmm.
And then the a shows you where that exchange is going to whom it's going. Okay? But... The le has to be there.
Yeah.
And so what you get is you get this, what appears to be a redundant use of the le, it's not. It's not redundant. The le has to be there.
Yeah, I suppose it's redundant because you already say a María or a Juan,
exactly.
A Pedro.
Yeah.
So if you're saying the noun, why do you use the pronoun when you have the noun?
Exactly.
Yeah, so that's why it's called redundant.
Yeah.
However, it's not used with every verb. When it has a pronoun in the third person. It's not with every verb. There are some verbs in which you will use the le plus a Pedro, a María, a Juan, okay? Mm. Or les, a ellos. Mm. And it's usually verbs like decir. This is a very, very important one because the amount of times you would say, I said to him, I said to her, le dije, contar as well, to tell.
Tell. Mm-hmm.
Preguntar, explicar. Which are the verbs?
All the communication verbs, all of the giving verbs.
Yeah.
But the fundamental basis of it is because we've been asked that many times, that means a lot, by the way, in Spain, we've been asked that many times for a definitive list of all of the verbs that demand the pronoun. And there's absolutely no need to do it. A, because you can't give a definitive list, because lots of verbs that use the le in certain contexts don't use the le in other ones. Some verbs are exchange verbs, and some verbs are just verbs of information. And that's how you need to distinguish. Is this verb exchanging? I'll give you an example. Okay, I could say, preparo un café. Okay, so I'm using preparar. Mm-hmm. Preparo un café. That's information. But if I say, le preparo un café a Cynthia, now I'm exchanging. There's an exchange of coffee. So preparar could be in the list for the use of the uh-huh, pronoun and in the list for not the use of the pronoun. So you can't have a list. What you've got to do is ask the question, is this verb an exchange verb? Is something being exchanged? I'm going to have to use le or the other pronouns. Or is it just information? And that's how you know. But in terms of the redundancy, if you want to, you can add the name for clarity. If you want to. You know, so I might, if I said to you, Cynthia, le preparé un café. Okay?
Of course, I would have to know who that le is.
And you would
same
ask.
Same in English. I made him a cup of tea.
Yeah.
Either I already know who that him is,
uh-huh.
Your dad, your brother, whatever, or you would have to give me more information.
And what question would you ask to get more information? Le preparé un café.
¿A quién?
A Pedro.
Mm-hmm.
Okay,
a Pedro.
So the a Pedro is just there for information so that you understand the sentence. Once we understand we're talking about Pedro, we won't keep putting Pedro in there.
Pedro's getting a coffee.
Pedro,
a
I know, he's a lucky.
Pedro, always. Pedro.
and I'm just taking him out now. I'm just taking him out. We enough of Pedro already. Let's get him out. And remember the rule, if you use le, if you're going to mention the name, it has to have a in front of it. Yeah? Because if you say, le preparó un café Pedro, that means something completely different. That means Pedro has made somebody a coffee. Yeah? So the a is always the receiver of the exchange. Yeah? That's mm-hmm. That's what it's about. So let's finish with a couple of examples of a couple of verbs that catch us out because we're looking for verbs of exchange.
Well, you're exchanging something in the examples you're going to give.
Yes, but these catch us out because we don't always think of them as an exchange, and that is to tell somebody something. Okay, but what you're actually doing, and that's with the verb decir, yeah, you are giving them some information. Okay, you're exchanging information with them. And for that reason, I would say, le digo a Cynthia que la quiero.
Oh, qué bonito.
Okay?
Sí.
So, le digo a Cynthia.
Could have gone everywhere.
It could have gone, yeah. Que no fui yo. It wasn't me. And now in that sentence, le digo a Cynthia... Okay, I can take Cynthia out. I don't need to have that in, but I can't take le because I'm exchanging some information with her. And it's the same with the verb preguntar. Okay, because again, asking somebody a question, you're kind of doing this exchange of a question, information exchange. Right, and nearly all the communication verbs need that le when you're communicating with somebody. Yeah? So you do one for me about asking me.
Le pregunté a Gordon ayer si quería ver una serie de Netflix conmigo.
Okay. So I le pregunté a Gordon.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. The sentence will not hold water, won't hold anything, in fact, if you say pregunté a Gordon.
Pregunté a Gordon.
No. Doesn't sound right, does it?
No. Sounds like it's missing something.
Yeah.
So that when we talk about redundant indirect object pronoun, we only refer to le or les.
Mm-hmm.
Les for the plural, for they.
Yeah.
Okay? Le or les. Not for the rest, obviously, because then you wouldn't need the third person.
You wouldn't use the name.
You wouldn't use the name.
Exactly.
And you can omit the name, the noun, but you can't omit the pronoun.
The le.
The le.
Or
the
les.
Yeah?
Exactly.
So, le dije a Gordon, les dije a mis padres, le pregunté a mi hermana, les pregunté a mis amigos, okay?
Yeah.
But I could say, le dije, les pregunté, whatever you asked. You don't have to say a mis amigos, so that would be the extra information.
Yeah. So, for example, just to finish, I'll give you an example of how we use the name, but we don't overuse it. So I can say, oh, ayer le dije a Sebastián que tenía que hacer su tarea.
Sí.
Y también le dije que tenía que fregar los platos. Okay?
Muy bien.
So,
muy bien.
The second time, I've used Sebastián, so Cynthia knows who I'm talking about, but the second time I won't say, y le dije a Sebastián. That would be redundant.
There's no need.
You know, so once your listener understands who the le stands for,
you mention the name
so
people
know who it is, and then leave it out. Okay? But for clarity,
that would be like,
and obviously, if Cynthia said to me,
I told Sebastián that he had to tidy up his bedroom. And I told Sebastián that, no, you wouldn't say that, you would say, I told Sebastián, blah, blah, blah. And I also told him that.
Exactly.
Yes.
So it becomes
the only
him.
Thing to remember is that you would have to say him, even though you say Sebastián in the first example.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. So there you are. That was for Yasin Khan and for everybody, really. It wasn't just for him, but he suggested it. Just so you know, everything that we've talked about is in this book. Okay, perfecting the pronouns in Spanish. So if you find the pronouns generally a bit of a challenge, this is the book that will sort it out for you, okay? And it's available on Amazon. Entonces, chicos, eso es todo. Y ahora nos vamos.
Y nos vemos.
Hasta luego. Adiós.
Adiós.